checking it out. Turned up the mic. We'll see how that goes. Hopefully it's not blaringly loud, but we'll see. Howdy. Got a few things to do on my son's Kia Sportage. It recently failed its inspections. Needs new oxygen sensors. Got some errors there. Also, there's a ground problem on this turn signal on the passenger side. And also, passenger mirror was cracked, and I need to replace that with something that'll at least pass inspection, which will mean running to the store later and getting some mirror replacement film thing that's fairly cheap instead of buying a whole new mirror, which will be way, way more than we need to do. So on the screen, you can see the main screen. We have the camera on an oxygen sensor. That's the top front before cat oxygen sensor. We're going to try to get that out. There's four oxygen sensors. This is a V6. So there's two that go for the front three cylinders and two that go to the back three cylinders. So we're going to end up replacing all four of those. So we'll see how that goes. Alright, so let's get going. I pulled the under tray out already. I also pulled broken glass out of that mirror already. So hopefully that works out well. So the hardest part is going to be reaching the top back oxygen sensor, which is back there. We may have to reach it from the other side. I do have the heaters going, so it is quite getting warm in here, actually. Alright, first thing I'm going to try to do is follow the wires to get them unplugged. I might have to move this camera. We'll see. So this wire right here, I have to figure out where that goes. It seems to go under the cylinder head over there at some point. Let's see. Kind of need a mirror. Mirror would be good. Maybe I'll grab the scope. I'm gonna turn the heater off. Probably could hear that for a second because it's blazing and the heater's right now perched on top of the toolbox that has the scope in it. heater off the toolbox before it burns me. Or anything else. Okay. Endoscope, that's the word I was looking for. Please have power. I don't see any power. Blah. Okay, so let's plug that in for a little while to charge. Meantime, let me spray a little penetrating oil on these oxygen sensors. Hopefully give myself a little bit easier time. Go down, see if I can reach this bottom one. Here's where the fat guy rolls on the floor. All right. Oil penetrated. Sorry for stealing your light. Who has the oxygen sensor tool set? I'm not sure which ones we'll be using. We'll see what we can fit in. I don't think I can get this one, even though this is my favorite. Might be able to get it in the bottom one. Not sure on that. Forgot we gotta try to track down those wires first too. Sorry, just putting some tools away. Try to put them away as much as possible, just so I don't make a huge mess, but I'm gonna make a huge mess anyway, so at least sometimes I'll be able to find things again. Okay. Sorry for bumping the mic. Yeah, that's why I got the endoscope out, to try to see down in here. I feel you. You're all part of this bundle. Question is, can I disconnect it somehow without breaking stuff? I don't know. Can't really tell. There's a couple of plugs all kind of wrapped up together, and I can't really feel them enough to. Oh. Cancel that. Okay. That. Problem is, like, there's a few plugs that are like, oh, they're like mounted to the same little bracket, and like, you can't like release one without releasing all of them. I'll pull the camera back a little bit, you can kind of see I got this one. Right behind the oil dipstick there. I got this one unplugged. You can kind of see the gray plug down there. But this plug next to it is kind of in the way. I need to, this is like attached to a bracket. I need to unattach it. Because that is what is actually attached to the oxygen sensor down below. Or not down below, right here on top actually. It just wraps around, you can see. It's all part of the same cord. I'm gonna move the camera. tripping over the cord. Try putting you guys over here. Out. Not terrible. Definitely easier from this side, I think. Now, I don't really care if these clip back to where they started from when I'm done, but what I'm gonna do is grab a new oxygen sensor so I can at least see what the little attachment clips look like. Two of them are the top for the top before the catalytic converters, and two of them are for the bottom after the catalytic converters. That's basically how oxygen sensors work, is they compare the exhaust gases before and after the catalytic converters to make sure the catalytic converters are working and that your air fuel mixtures are proper. Okay, so these are actually have two different numbers. I don't know if you can see that or not. This top number is the same, but these two numbers are different. So one's probably front, one's probably rear. And we can see. See, this is now 329 Sportage. Front and rear, or downstream rear, is 24461, and downstream front is this guy. Okay, nice they put that on there, so I don't have to look it up online. Okay, I don't know if you guys can see that or not, but there it is. Okay, so. Upstream ones are these three. So any of these will have the same clip. Ooh, fancy zip ties even. Okay, there is our oxygen sensor. Let's cut off this other zip tie. Okay, these always come with protective caps. That's fine, we'll leave that on for the moment. Okay, so we can see this little clip. Basically, got to be pushed in to release it from the bracket slides up and locks in. So we need to push that in to release it from the bracket. Okay. How are we going to do that? I don't know. Okay, we're borderline gonna break some stuff. Just so we're not here for hours and hours and hours. Which we'll probably will be anyway, but whatever. Just pulling hard enough. No. Okay, let's try long skinny screwdriver maybe. Alright, no luck with that. Let's try a small pick tool. Try a little pick tool. See if that does anything.
There we go. It's enough wiggle force to get it off. Now, it's attached somewhere. Okay. Let's see if we can get the tool in there. Sorry. Not the best, but it'll have to do for the moment. Yeah, we'll go with that. Oops. It's down there somewhere. Unfortunately, we gotta do a lot of this by feel, because things are just slightly inaccessible. Okay, so now we have the full cord. Good. And now, see, this is going to be a pain. I don't really want to take this radiator out. I've had it out before. I've had this whole front end off before. Because I have done an air conditioning compressor in here. I've done an alternator in here. It's all fun. Not really. Which is not a lot of room there. Just not. Really don't want to drain coolant. Let's see if I can get that in there. Let's move you again so you can see what's going on. Okay, so get that there, but now can I get a tool in there? Breaker bar, even just the regular ratchets. So, after looking a few things up on my phone, the check engine codes that are being thrown right now are actually for the ones that are after the cats, which may make it a little easier to get at. So we're going to try that and see what happens instead of trying to... I know we spent a lot of time trying to get this one unplugged and etc., but we can always put it right back together. So let's try attacking the bottom ones because they are much easier to look to reach than the top ones, thankfully. And at this point, not super concerned if this wire flops around just a tiny bit. Sorry about the camera flopping around more than a tiny bit. Get you out of there. About that. Okay, should be all right. Let's go down underneath and see what we get. I need those. Okay. Whoosh around the garage, sorry. Headlight. Datsun. Okay. Let's see. Okay, so I'm right underneath the bumper and this oxygen sensor is right there. If you can see that. If I can leave you there, that would be a pretty good view. Let's go inside here. Sorry for darkness. See if I can get this to stay somewhere. Probably not. Okay, let's go from the floor on this light. Can you see that? You see a lot of shadows, is what you see. Let's see. Gonna see a shadow there. Okay, let's try you in a different spot. This light was not the greatest place either. Oops. turned off my light. Different orientation. That's just not good either. Light it up. Kind of okay. So the action sensor's right here. Okay. Pretty good on the screen. Now, can I? Get the oxygen sensor socket on here. Let's see. Where's that plug go? It goes up that way, okay. Be able to use that one. Let's look at the other one. Okay. Can I get this? There. Yep. Okay. Breaker bar is in here. Whoops. Making a mess. Come on, tools, hang up where you belong. Thank you. Pay no attention to the mess. Just the way it is. Oh, goodness. Whatever. All right, still got a good view. Alright, well, let's see. I just want to break this loose since I haven't undone the wires yet. I don't want to twist it too far. Not that it matters, because I'm taking this out. And this is not gonna fit in there because of this bracket. Guess I can bring it out. Enter two. Let's see what we got. Use this guy. And see what happens. Get your butt in there. Yo. Yeah, I need to go to a ratchet. I don't have enough distance on that. The other socket. This is actually a half inch drive. Adapter. I really hate these things. you. Oh, so dirty.
Heads up. I think she moved. Okay, let's track this wire. Okay, I'll show you what I'm looking at. Okay, so I can't reach those from up here very well. Looks like I'm gonna have to reach from underneath. What fun! Blech. Plug, I believe. Okay, that's good. Now I'm just gonna push this little button. There we go. Alright. Okay then. Alright. Well, my hands are even dirtier than before. That's great. But now should be able to take this off. Camera back, let's get the light back. Hello.
cordless lights would are really preferred. How's that? There. I thought they're still right there. Here's our cord pointing right at you. So we slip our nut over the cord. Our issue is our nut or our socket won't fit over. Let's see, what if we go backwards? Maybe that'll fit better. Might give us a little more room. Hits the exhaust pipe. Okay, so from there I can get about an eighth of a turn if I'm lucky. Once these things break free, they're usually not super terrible to get off, but it's the initial breaking free that sucks. Like, I'm literally turning it with my hands at this point, but it's got a little tighter since I moved it. Okay, progress. Can I get the rest off? Yes. Okay. There's our oxygen sensor, our old one. This is throwing codes for too high a voltage, which means it's reading incorrectly, and also for not reading at all, which is obviously an issue. Okay, so our new one will go in there, plug back in where we had it. Let's grab it. Alright. I had hand cleaner down here. Guess not. Okay, do I have anti-seize? I do. Anti-seize. So the anti-seize is what's will hopefully, if anybody else ever needs to take this out again, it's not that hard to take out. These things rust into the exhaust pipes really easily, etc. Okay, so let's read our box again to make sure we got the right sensor. We want front downstream, which is the other one. Okay, so this has got to go back in this box so I don't screw it up. And now we have this one, which is the oddball. So special, it has white zip tie clamps, clips, whatever. I'm sure it'll look pretty similar to the other one. Okay, there's our oxygen sensor. We'll put anti-seize on these threads right here, and then we'll put her back in. Don't need a ton, because it'll just squirt out everywhere. Enough to coat. Okay, so coat all those threads. Should be good to go. A little bit on that washer. And install. Come on. That threaded that it wasn't. Let's see. You should definitely want to make sure you're not cross threading or anything like that. By hand here. I really commend the Hyundai and Kia engineers who made this so easily accessible. Just one of those things that's just barely accessible without taking a lot of stuff apart, but not in the easiest fashion. I'm gonna blame Kia on this. Hyundai made this engine, but Kia is responsible for this chassis, so. Piece of cake if I could have got the socket, the straight line socket, silver one I had earlier, in here. So much easier. Less than a quarter turn at a time. Okay, not smack ourselves in the face. That got pretty tight, pretty quick. Wrong end of the ratchet. Let's take a look. Pretty well seated on that washer. Okay, let's pull you guys back up here so you can watch us plug it back in. Where I was able to stick the light is really in the way of where I need to put my hands. Okay, so we got a bracket over here, just a little bit of a wire channel. Sorry about blocking your view. You shall see my dirty hands. In there. Well, I guess this thing is quite long enough. I don't want to put too much pressure on that oxygen sensor. I don't give a shit if this attaches again, but I'll put it over top. I mean, it attaches to the bracket, not attaches to the plug. Direction, or the other way? Here's the other way. These things usually go in one way. Heard it click. It's nice. Supposed to click backside. Yeah, there's a really hard to manage these one-handed. I'm just leaving it there. We're away from anything super hot. I did lose. Sorry, my arm is just totally wedged in here. I don't have much movement except for my fingers. Let's see if I can get the other hand in here. Not really, that's as far as I can go. I move the light. Let's see. Get in anywhere else a little closer. There we go. All right. Good with that. Okay. One down, one to go. Now, this next one is back underneath. So it attaches to this pipe here, back up here. So I will put you guys back here for a sec. As we prepare to try to grab that other one. Get this. I got a power strip under here that's attached to this light that is in the way. It is not the way, it is in the way. And you are looking at my snow shovel there. I'll move you guys in a sec. Yep, still dirty. Okay. I need to move these carpets in a little bit. I need them. Let's see. I'll get you guys up. Oops. Hello. Look, see. Alright. This light is in the wrong spot. So, I think we're gonna put you guys up in here. Okay, here's our oxygen sensor. Once again, in a horrible place. Although I might be able to get the straight socket in there from the wheel well. Let's see. That's right in your way. Let's see. Is that even in any kind of focus? Possibly. Alright. I'm gonna shut you guys off for a minute because my wife just came home. I'll see what she's got going on. Be right back, audio wise. Alright, we're back. I guess the wife didn't want to come see me. Alright, good for me. Alright, so now we got it traced out. I don't know if you saw just now, but I was able to turn that oxygen sensor pretty easily right here. But I do need to trace the wires up and see where they go and unplug said wires. I love it because it's nice and wet underneath here. That just makes it so much fun. I couldn't be working on this yesterday when it wasn't snowing in the morning. Alright. Cord goes up past the alternator. Thank you. the alternator was a huge pain in the ass to do. Literally had to take out the drive axle to get the alternator out. There's the drive axle right here. Alternator right above it, that direction. Oh, and I'm getting wet. I just leaned in a puddle. That's great. Alright, I'm gonna try and look from the top and see if I can see that plug. Because it goes around the alternator. Hopefully I didn't accidentally capture it in the alternator wiring when I installed that alternator a couple months ago. Alright, sorry, you're gonna be dark for a sec. Well, oh, your struggle bus. I'll leave your light back here. And grab a different one from up top. Hooah. Alright, where are you? Here you are. I'm guessing it's right there. Is my guess. What a pain in the ass. Bring out the big guns. About now, alright. As I said before, my wife was coming to say hello. So very nice of her. Okay, I got the plug, yes. To find the little clippy clippy clip, push the button. I think that's the button. Come on. Can feel it. Can't get it. Just gonna move this back a little. Use the fridge as some stability. Alright. Oh, this way. You might be seeing the wire move. Oh, I think I clicked it. Oh. Come on. I can feel it sort of clicking. Or unclicking, how do you want to say it? I'm gonna let go. Sucker. Again. I don't want to hurt my tummy anymore. How about that? Ah, so much more comfortable. Clang, clang, bounce, bounce. Hurt my eyes. That ain't good. What's that? That's not bad. There we go. Just needed a different finger on it. In this case, it was the index finger. I'm just leaving that light there for now. Alright, back underneath to get that back oxygen sensor off. Shouldn't be a problem. It loosened up real easily, actually, surprisingly. scratchy. That was like a piece of fuzz or something on a microphone windscreen, and it was rather annoying on my chin. Alright, so got our cord down. Now I just need to keep unscrewing. Try not to fully engage this ratchet into the socket, because as I loosen, it's kind of pushing the ratchet handle into the frame. You can hear it clink, clink, clink. If I pull the oxygen sensor out too far, I may not be able to undo the ratchet. Let's see, can we do this with my hand? No. No. Okay. Keep going. Ta-da! Alright. That was a nice noise. Ka-ding! Alright, so this guy's out. And we'll put the new one in. Okay. Okay. Hopefully this one's long enough. This is the one we just had out before. I think I am going to actually plug it in first and drop it down so that, because running cords upwards against gravity just tends to make it hard. Anti-seize. There she is. Anti-seize, a little bit here. Threads and washer again. Anti-seize is a really good cleaner, actually. Took the grease right off my hands. Funny. Alright, so back into the car with this. Oh, I lied. Remember, I'm gonna plug it in first. Where'd my booster chair go? Okay. Drop this down. Pass the alternator. Thankfully, this was not attached to any kind of bracketry. go gadget, clip together, snap. All right, got the snap. You guys can probably see this a whole lot better than me. Okay, headed down. Okay, pour the light off. Booster chair, you're done again. Boing. And I'm almost getting used to this up and down on the floor thing. Alright, yeah, you guys definitely saw. Oh, that was stupid. I can't plug it in first. Okay, lesson learned. Because I didn't think about it. You can't plug the oxygen sensor in first because you need it to spin. And if it spins, it'll twist the wires all up. Back to the booster chair. Alright, that was dumb. That was dumb. At least I caught it before I started twisting it. But it's going to be fun. It's not going to be terrible to get it up here. I got pretty good access. Pulling on the wrong side of the harness doesn't help. Makes it really hard. Okay, round two. Booster chair, I'm gonna need you again. So, you're just out of the way for the moment. Okay, and we back. Started nicely. Nicely threaded. Let's get as far by hand as we can. Which is actually pretty far. Okay, wrench, reverse direction. Good. Yep. Crush the washer. Good to go. Alright, so now we just need to get this cord, these wires, up past the alternator. Well, just got behind the alternator would work. And kind of reach down there. See if I can reach that from above. Whew. Up, down, up, down, up, down. There's a country song like that. I know there's a country song like that. What am I talking about?
breaker bar. Let's try not to break anything while we're putting the breaker bar away. Okay. Back up. Let's reach. Okay. Feel the altar here. Do not feel any plugs. Okay. Get the other light. Try this again. Booster chair out of the way. Guessing it probably fell down or something. Yeah, if I can get it over there, I can reach it. Pretty sure. Oop, booster chair. Ah, I see it. Just don't knock it down again. I think I see it, and click, awesome, good to go. All right, okay. This belly pad. And I need a screwdriver. Let's go with this first. We need the booster chair. So, in the past, I have had to repair this light because whatever ground wire it connects to on this whole lighting sensors assembly here, not sensor, just assembly, the ground was bad. Somewhere in the harness, the ground went bad. So I don't know where that ground attaches to or what, but the headlight stopped working. It was really dim, actually. It didn't stop working. It was just really dim. So I had run another ground wire to the headlight circuit. Let me show you what I'm doing. Instead of looking at an oxygen sensor that is installed already, come with me, people. I shall set you free. Just kidding. I have no power to do that.
That was my butt. That's what I thought. Okay. Alright, so here's our headlight assembly. At least the back side of it. I see I temporarily just wired that ground wire. And I just unscrewed it from here. But there is something else going on, I believe. Because the turn signal is acting like it doesn't have a, it has a bulb out, basically. Alright, I just put you on mute for a second again. My wife and daughter want to run out to the store and get the mirror, replacement mirror stuff. Let me get that out of order. Thank you.
Let's try mic now. Yes, we have microphone. All right. Sorry for the delay. Just had to place an order with the parts store. Wife and daughter are going to go drive and get that in a few minutes. And that's just to show you there. Here's the glass from the mirror, of the side mirror over here. Broke. So I'm just going to replace that mirror surface. They have like a universal mirror coating thing. I may have to make a piece of plexiglass that fits in there properly. Doesn't have to be perfect, just has to pass inspection. So that's what we'll do next. While we're waiting on parts, we will go and check out the lighting situation. And let's check out the headlights and see. What's going on here? Key in my pocket? I believe so. Wrong ones. Right ones. Booster chair, out of the way. You can still hear me? Oh yeah, look at that. Find the keyhole. There it is. Oh. Bong bong. Alright, I don't know if you can hear that clicking. Let's turn the fan off. That's the right turn signal. Clicky, clicky, clickies. And I'm sure you'll see. Yeah, I got no headlight over here. Let's see what happens when I ground it. Headlight. Headlight. Okay, I'm guessing there's probably a ground issue with this bulb. You can see this bulb going clicky, clicky, clicky. Just don't know why. Alright, so let me get this back in for this headlight. I don't think there was anything wrong with that. Ooh. Ooh. That was pretty cool. It actually got toasty warm. Got a headlight. Okay. I mean, technically it could be an issue with the rear light, too. We'll have to trace it and see. I mean, the issue is that it is we're gonna figure out where the harness is for this. Maybe I'll take this bulb out. Not sure. Alright, I don't want to drain the battery. Especially with the lights on. Alright, this light, that, there's... Oh. I see. So, this is supposed to be lit, and it's not, which is probably why that's going. Gotcha. Okay, so what runs that? Don't know. Okay, let's figure it out. Now I see, just because that it is a missing bulb. This bulb, right in the bottom. Alright, so let's switch scenes then. Okay, that'll work, I think. So now, I mean, you'll still be able to see what's going on back here. Maybe. How about that? That's not bad. Let's go down a little bit. Alright. Perfect! Dun 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 dun. Da, 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 da. I mean, that might not, just might not be plugged in. It's hard to say. This is a fairly new headlight. Who knows? My son is notoriously hard on cars, mainly because he doesn't give a crap. He doesn't care about maintenance. He doesn't care about driving like an idiot. So. Let me see. Don't super recall how that comes out. I don't recall these being the clips that I've worked with before, but this car has been in a collision shop since then, since I've worked on it, so. Another one of his many stories of messing cars up. This kid has had more cars that I have purchased than I have, that's for sure, in the last, I mean, he's only 21. I actually just turned 22, didn't he? Yeah, he just turned 22. So, in less than 6 years of driving, he's had, I think six cars. Had access to six cars. Let's see. He had a Passat wagon. He had a Civic. He had a Taurus that got. Well, we bought it from like a just kind of like side of the road dealer. Guy had a dealer's license, but he just basically bought cars at auction and fixed them up and then sold them. Well, he didn't fix this one up. Literally, we pulled the carpet back and there were holes in the floor. Like, not just little holes. Like, you could put your foot all the way through without touching any metal holes. So, that really wasn't his fault, but that car went bye-bye real quick. Oh, no camera if you're unplugged. Let's try it again. Are we back? Not back yet. Might have to reboot that. Let's see. Helps if you don't step on the cord. No. Is there a refresh source kind of thing? How did that make me lose? Oh, I don't have an audio in here. So you guys lost music when I switched scenes. Now you got music back, huh? Interesting. I mean, you could probably hear some music through my mic, but... Did I get this live feedback or not? No. That's just a static image right now. Huh. Interesting. Interesting. So, hopefully that's probably echoey. Who knows? What's that? Alright, if I switch this, try that again. I think we should be live now. Hey, come move your fingers. Okay. Alright, so I'm gonna leave. Well, let's just fix it while we're here so I don't forget about it. Sorry, no more music. Until we add. That one. Alright. So now you should have music. In the scene. Alright. Yes, you have music.
So you guys can see, like a little plug down here. No, it's under there. It's right behind the air conditioning line. This plug. You can't really see it from there. How about now? It's back here. Plug to this bottom light. Sorry about that. Noises. Take a look at my hand. Now what? Let's get something to squeezy. Nope. This clip is really, really tight. Really not going to go around where I need to go around. See, can you guys see that plug better than I can over here? Sorry, that's not a great view. Saying it. Can't really get you where I want you to be. You don't quite fit where I need you to be. Sort of in the right spot. banging all around. Hopefully you're not totally sick at this point. But you might be. It's just terrible. Yeah. Terrible. Okay, anyway. Back to where you were. Nope. What the heck is going on here? Where, how did I have it before? What the heck? Sorry about it. Let's see, what are you looking at now? Let's see about that. That's pretty good, because we need to get this plug right here. It's behind this hose. This plug back here. Alright, so need to push this button and an identical button on the other side. Let's get a tool that might be able to do it. I guess it is only just one side. Okay, I think that shut off all the lights on that side. try it and see. Okay. Still have rear.
Hey, honey.
Okay. Okay. In case you need to know that, my dog's not getting his flea collar until spring. Good to know. Okay, so yeah, definitely nothing works on that side. Everything goes through that harness. Okay. Okay, should give us some more room. Well, it's a pain in the ass to reach. So let's use a tool. Okay, let's see if this ball works. Looks fine. Looks fine. Doesn't look blown. Let's put some voltage on it and see what happens. Light works fine. Nope. Oh. Did I just blow it? No. Okay, so. Oops. Light works fine. Okay, so it's not the bulb. Okay, so we're gonna put this back in. Make sure it's going the right direction. There's no direction. Just make sure it works in the socket. Which goes to which? That side's positive. Doesn't matter, but okay, so that works in the socket. Okay. Come on. Get in there. Align yourself, fool. Let's go. There it is. Okay, that's reseated. I'm gonna have to take this harness out or apart and see what's going on there. Let's see, sometimes just plugging and unplugging can do wonders. Oh, back to how many cars my son has had in 6 years. So, I said Passat, we said Civic, we said Taurus, we said, well, this obviously Kia Sportage. Oops. He had a Subaru. Hey, look, it works. Just had to reseat that bulb, or that plug, or the other. Okay. That's good. I do need to reset the check engine light. Before I do that, let's put a few more things back together. Make sure this is all the way in. That's loose. So let's tighten that. Okay. Two bolts to put in, one for the washer fluid neck. Okay. Washer fluid, I don't think I do. It's alright. Coolant's good, sorry for shaking. Okay, got one more screw for this light. Okay, that's good. Clean up tools and cords. And we'll come back over here. Well, we can come over here. You can see a startup, I guess. Oops. Not in love with that spot. Yeah, it's not terrible. You can see the new serpentine belt going round and round.
tools away while we have them in our hands. And there's the phone. Be right back. Alright, sorry about that. Wife called. I accidentally ordered from the wrong location for the auto parts. So I had to call and cancel one store, and she bought it from a different store. My bad. Kind of stinks when you have two of the same store brands on the same street. The street's kind of long, so it's it all comes out the same street name. You just gotta pay attention to which basically street number or that it for. I didn't. No problem though. All right, so I think we're good to start her up. Let's give her a go. Oh, I do want to. Yeah, I'll cancel or I'll erase the codes that we have first. More tools go away. Alright, code reader. You are. I definitely need a new code reader. This one's so old. And if there's multiple codes, this thing like locks itself up. It's so stupid. So it shows like the first code in the list and then it just stops. You can't move through the list. It basically says, nah. Detecting and erase. Yes. Erase was successful. No codes. And you guys can see the engine running. Got no check engine light at this time, which is good. Let it warm up for a sec. Better open the garage. Squeaky, squeaky pulley, I hear. You guys come with me. Here's our broken mirror that we're going to fix. And squeeze in the door because I can't fit. Got, we do have a TPMS light. Car is usually out of gas because he never puts any in, but no check engine light. So we are good in that respect. Okay, so I guess that's it for that part. He is due for an oil change, so I'll probably do that. Let me shut this guy off. Hi. Alright. I'm going to put on my coat. Get her off. Let's make sure I have oil for him. I don't think I have a filter, though. What filter does he need? 9688. I don't think I have. I have some for my wife, but not for him. Alright, well, that was an aggressive schedule for oil changes anyway. He doesn't need it right now. Let me just make sure he has some oil. Okay, I'm going to get the garage back open. Get it off the ramps. I got it under engine undercover to put on first. Let's do that. Need 12 and 13s. Where did I put the socket? There it is. That. Okay, I guess you can come with me under the sea. Comes my parts. Thank you. Okay, we'll do that in a minute. They put the stoutest screws on this stupid piece of plastic. It just kills me. Okay, let's find our other screws. I think they are over here. Yes. Okay, and last one in front. Okay, and of course switched sizes to 12 millimeter there for this last one, which is farther back.
solid. When it failed inspection, they also questioned, they didn't fail them, but questioned the tie rod ends, which on the back side, so looks like we might have a little split in that boot, but I can't. Not something I'm going to worry about. Everything else looks pretty good. Let's see this. Coming off is, I mean, I replaced that less than 2 years ago. This whole pipe was replaced. I just noticed that now. Stupid. Or if he ran something over, it's likely. Anyway, let's move on to our mirror, which is the last official thing keeping us from being inspected. Okay. So here's what we got. It's basically like an acrylic sheet that goes over top of a broken mirror. I think it's going to be too thin to place right on our plastic here. So, there it is, see? Let's switch scenes back. Toolbox. Here's that extremely active chat. Just kidding. There's the rest of our computer, toolbox, etc. Alright, so let's look at our mirror here. See what we gotta do. Stupid thing. You rip the hell out of it. Nope. There's an opening. I like this warning. You can see. If you have a concave mirror, you will start fires. Okay. Try not to concave the mirror. Stuff isn't the greatest, but it should pass inspection. But it, I don't think I need much in the way of backing. I mean, it's not really going to distort much. This has a coating on it too. How much did that distort the mirror? Oops. Is there? Peel off the side. Peel off the side. Just the one side? Maybe just one side. Where's the directions?
It says, trace your mirror. Cut it out with scissors. If your damaged mirror has multiple broken bits and pieces, best to remove the broken glass. Which I did. Use a hammer to break off any leftover pieces of glass.
Nah, I don't think so.
Peanuts from the front of the lens. Yeah, there's protective mirror on the front as well. Okay. Maybe that's why it's so liney. Okay, so let's see. You want it to be like that. And let's markerify the green one here. Should work. Okay. Do I have scissors in here? I do. Now that was an outside tracing. We need to actually cut it in quite a bit into this tray. If we get it nicely, it could tuck it under this edge too. So let's see. I'm gonna make another line. Different color. How about red? Go red and green for Christmas. Doesn't have to be much to tuck under that edge, so. Okay. See how that goes. This is pretty tough to cut. Do I have tin snips in here? Let's see. Not in there, I don't. Probably outside in my other tool area. So let's just try. That's really tough. Well, it's not terrible. Thank you. hard on the fingers, that's for sure. All right. Now, does she fit? It's close. It's real close. Oh. I like it, lucky. To crack it a little bit. Okay, let's get this. Drop it. Okay, I'm just gonna take a tiny bit off of this edge. And a tiny bit off of this edge. So now, peel off the sticky side, supposedly. Wait a minute. Well, that doesn't matter, but I thought this was the sticky side. So, is this side the sticky side? That's gonna suck. Because if this side is the sticky side, I just ruined it. Double stick tape supplied. Oh, there's double stick tape. Thank you. It's really stupid that they... don't tell you which side is the mirror side. Like, the mirror side with the wrap looks duller than the non-mirror side. So this doesn't come off, is what you're saying. Okay, so what I'm going to do... is fudge this. Okay, let's see how that goes. I'm gonna have to buy another one anyway if this doesn't work, but. Gotta be close enough. It shall be deemed close enough. Can you see yourself? Not perfect. Not perfect at all. I can see my bicycles up there. In a minute. All right, adjust up. Give her a little cleaning. Check the oil, and then we'll be done. All right. I think that's gonna do it, folks. If anybody actually watches this, thanks for watching. Let me know if there's any issues. If you don't like something I did, too bad. I think I should have done something additional. Whatever. But if you do have questions, let me know. So far, so good. So, at this point, I'll talk to you guys later. Bye!